Hi guys, it's Shreya. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you're doing well, guys. I'm sorry for the delay regarding my videos. I've not been posting this stuff since last few days. So guys, one of the major aspects that I want to share with you all today is about the facial waxing. We basically tend to go on for face waxing and stuff because we think facial waxing is very safe. It is because what we can do for hair removing is what? We can shave our facial hairs, we can do waxing, we can go on for threading. But the reason being we consider facial wax is that it is the most safest one according to us. But hardly, guys, what we think is different from the reality, which is actually the thing that I want to share with you all is my personal experience regarding my facial wax through which I went through past 2 weeks back. So what happened is that, guys, I went for a facial wax of my face. I didn't went for the complete facial waxing, but I wanted to remove this side and this side, the facial hairs, which are basically over here on the side edge of my hairs. So I just wanted to remove them. And as a reason being, I also thought that threading might seem like a very time-taking one, and even it just make a whole lot of redness on your face, so you just cannot go anywhere after threading and all. And razor again being one of the thing which I'm scared of. I used to think that I might not get a cut, or I might not bring on a scar on my breakouts of the skin and stuff. So I just went for a facial waxing, and what happened, guys, was something not very good with me. I really got very heavy breakouts after my facial wax. And one more thing which happened was that my skin got burned. Yes, guys, it was not what we call as facial bumps, and it was not even what we call as the redness that appear on the face after waxing. No, it was a clear burn on my skin, and I got so many scars on my face. I'm going to insert a picture over here. As you can clearly see, it was really very visible. I was not being able to hide it anyway, because you cannot hide your face. How can you, right? You can hide your underarms, you can hide your arms and legs if you have got any scar over there, but hiding your face is like next to impossible. So I was not being able to go and attend any of the other, you know, important stuff. I just cannot step out for a good occasion and all, because it was really like really not looking good. And I was really very much upset. The reason being, whatsoever, I didn't know what was the reason behind. What I figured out was that basically when I went for the facial waxing, the beautician or the salon person who was doing the facial wax, they didn't told me this would happen. Okay, what do we think about facial waxing? The clear thing that we has in our mind is that we might get some of the bumps, we might have some of the breakouts, or our skin might even get red. It might even get severe red, but it will calm down sooner or later. But what I found was the clear burn. I got burnt over here. I got burn marks over here. I got burn marks over here. It was literally clear burnt, and it was very visible. And my skin turned out to be not just red. It turned out to be, you know, bluish red kind of. And it looked very shabby and really very upsetting. And the amount for the facial wax was not even less, guys. They charged me around 300 rupees for just this, for just taking out a patch of hair from here and just taking out a patch of hair from here, and for the upper lips. I didn't went for the complete facial waxing, no, because I don't go for complete facial waxing. The reason being, I have acne prone skin, so I just got this patch of hair to be scratched out, and the patch of hair from here to be removed out, and just upper lips. That's all I did, and I was charged for rupees 300. And one more thing I would like to, so I just thought that why not to share this experience with you all over there, because sooner or later at some or the other point we tend to go for facial waxing, and before doing anything we must know this thing. If I would have been known this before, I might have not gone through this experience. But the reason being, guys, I'm making this video is that first of all I want to mention few of the consequences that facial waxing has, and no or none of the beautician is going to tell us, because guys, why would they tell us? Look, not being that you know, unpractical, let's be practical. For them, we as a customer is the only reason to make out their money. They won't say no to their customer, obviously not, because for them we are a source of getting their income. So they won't say ki don't go for facial waxing or it is not good, it is not safe, yeah, they might tell you at some or the other point that you might get few of the redness on the skin, because that's for just keeping themselves as a side on the safer side, so that they can just say ki we told you before that your skin might turn bright red. But what we think is, yeah, redness is okay because it's going to go away in a day or two. But they'll never tell you that how the consequences are, how severe consequences are and the side effects are of facial waxing. So few of them I'm going to tell you briefly right now, guys. First of all, I would like to tell you that the redness which appear on our face is not something which can go on for 1 or 2 days. It might even appear to be very severe. It might take weeks to go. So please remember this thing before going for a facial wax. And especially I want to mention the people who are having very tender, gentle skin, all the teenagers over there. And one more thing I want to mention, the people who are having sensitive skin, don't ever go for facial waxing. This is my complete personal recommendation. Don't ever go for facial waxing if you're having a sensitive skin. Just don't. Just avoid it. And if you're a teenager, you're on the age of 16, 17, 18 or 19 even, avoid facial waxing if you can. If it's not that urgent, then try to avoid it as much as you can. One more thing I want to mention is that what happens when we do facial waxing, they just apply the facial strip and they pull it like this, as we all know. And while they are pulling it, our skin tends to become very loose. Our skin starts loosening if we tend to do facial waxing on a regular basis. So don't do a facial waxing on a regular basis. Just do it for like once in a month and when required, only then. One more thing what happens is, while we are using a facial wax, while we are pulling off the strips for doing facial waxing, what happens is sometimes the upper skin of our face, that is the epidermis, it comes out with the facial hair, and the coming out, the peeling of the epidermis of our skin tends to be a boom for infections. So fourth thing is that there is a major risk of infections being on our face just because of the epidermis being peeled off. Now, one of the major things is, while our epidermis or the upper skin of our face is peeled off, there might be the a very high risk that our skin starts bleeding. So if there is bleeding, obviously there is going to be infection. One more thing, guys, I want to mention is that while we're peeling off our skin with facial hairs, what happens is that few of the bacteria just tend to get, they just seeps inside our skin, because as our epidermis is removed, there's a clear passage for bacteria to go within our skin and create a whole lot of infections. One more and last thing is that many people have allergy with facial waxing. So please always do a patch test. Where I would like you to do a patch test is that behind your ears always, or just over here at side, you can just put some wax and strip it off. If you're having allergy, you'll see the allergic reaction in just 1 or 2 minutes. So guys, one more thing I want to mention is, now if you have just got a facial wax and you're having a slight redness, which is just normal, nothing as such big to be taken considered for. So what you can do to cure your redness and itching of the skin, just apply some or the other natural aloe vera gel. I would highly mention if you, I would recommend if you would use Wow Skin Science aloe vera gel, because they say it's 99% pure aloe vera. So it's going to just soothe your skin. Aloe vera is great for soothing your skin. So you can use aloe vera wherever your skin is being peeled off or you have got a wax. One thing I would mention again, which is very important, please don't go outside or don't expose yourself to the sun after you have got wax, because what happens is when you go out to the sun, you might get sun allergic reactions very soon, because your skin is very gentle, it's very tender. While your skin is being peeled off, your hairs are being peeled off, so your skin is at high risk to get allergic reactions because of sun exposure. So avoid sun exposure after you have got wax, at least for 1 or 2 hours. Don't go to the sun outside. One more thing, if you have got any or the other burnt marks, like the way I got, I really got very bad severe burnt marks, guys. And I, the way I cured it, just I know it took me more than 2 weeks to cure my face, you know, guys. So I would never go on for facial wax, that's for sure. How I cured my skin is, I just applied coconut oil before going to the bed. Pure coconut oil. I used Patanjali coconut oil before going to the bed. I just applied it all over my marks, wherever there were marks. I did it for 1.5 weeks, and during the daytime I didn't apply anything rather than aloe vera gel, and it healed my skin, it soothed my skin, and now you can see it is clear. There is nothing as such. So that's all for this video, guys. I hope this video was really very helpful for you. Please share this with all the girls over there, with your family, friends, where it is, everyone. Like this video, guys, if it was anyhow helpful for you. Do subscribe to my channel if you have not yet. Take care of your guys. Love you all. Bye-bye.